We're shaking, folks. Back with another reaction, back with some more Tears of Fears, and we're going to the 1996 compilation album once again, Saturnine Martial and Lunatic. And we're up to the tune called My Life in the Suicide Ranks. It's a very stark title. It makes me a little edgy or uncomfortable. It could be perhaps figurative or metaphorical, not necessarily actually taking one's own life, but perhaps engaging in self-damaging behavior knowingly, sometimes seen as a cry for help, but the idea of sort of making choices which will cause problems and stress and tension in your own life, but for whatever reason doing so deliberately. Also, there's an oxymoronical quality to it, a sort of contradictory quality. If you are in the suicide ranks, then you don't really have a life, so you can't really describe or characterize your life if you have joined the suicide ranks. And then saying suicide ranks is itself an interesting choice. The idea of a sort of group of people who have all chosen to throw in their lot with that decision, which again, if you've done that, then you don't really have a life to speak of. So whether we're talking figuratively or more literally, it's a really interesting title, and one that again is a bit edgy, a bit sort of dark and uncomfortable. So we'll see what it's all about. This is Tears of Fears. The track is My Life in the Suicide Ranks, and it's from the 1996 compilation album Saturnine Martial and Lunatic. Oof. Track.
Outside.
ourselves to be very experimental and exploratory from time to time. That was maybe the most abstract tune I've heard from them, one of them anyway. And again, there was already one earlier in this compilation album that had a similar sort of out there vibe, which reminds me, I think it was Michael who was saying, like, oh, I think the next one is like that. I think it was the one, you know, we skipped Schrodinger's Cat, which again, that's such an amazing tune. I really, really love that track. I've been re-listening to it. But yeah, I believe this is probably the one that Michael was thinking of, because that had a, like, just insane vibe, and I've never heard a vocal delivery like that. I'm not even sure, like, was that Roland? It did, like, obviously, whoever it is going to sort of a style and a place that would make their voice less familiar than normal. But even so, I don't know if that was Roland. So yeah, let me know, like, is that Kurt? Is this from a time when Kurt was still in the group? Or is that actually Roland just doing things that, despite me being amazed at multiple points at what he can do with his voice, is that something like that I didn't even know he could do beyond his already incredible range? Because yeah, I'm just not sure what I was hearing there, other than, you know, the word insanity in a very creative and sort of avant-garde way. So yeah, really interesting track. Again, maybe not a track that you put on a like proper studio album, but one that is really cool to have in their catalog. So let me know what you think. I will see you next time. Peace.